In part 5 of our lesson on graphs of tangent and cotangent, you will learn how to write the equation for a function given its graph. In this example, we're being asked to determine two possible equations for the graph. One will be a tangent, and one will be a cotangent. So let's start off by writing the standard forms. We know it will look like y equals a tangent of b times x minus c plus d, or it will be y equals a cotangent of b times x minus c plus d. And our job is to find a, b, c, and d for each function. We know that the absolute value of a tells us the vertical stretch or compression of the function. Now, normally, we know that from the middle of the 5 key values out to the next, either up or down, should be a distance of 1. Now we can see on this graph here that this distance is 2, which tells us that the absolute value of a is going to be 2. Now you could also do this as a calculation if you don't recognize that right away, and you can do 1/2 of the upper value, which we see is 1, minus the lower value, which is negative 3, 1/2 of 4 is equal to 2. So we know that the absolute value of a equals 2. And hopefully you're going to recognize that you can just look at this and start to see that stretch and just write it down. That's fine. Now we have to decide if a is positive or negative. Now, for the tangent graph, we see that this is going in the same direction as the unaltered tangent. So for tangent, it's not flipped. Which means that a has to be positive, so a is going to equal 2. So let's go up here and start to write our tangent graph. We've got y is equal to 2 times the tangent of the quantity. Let's go ahead and finish our tangent function, then we'll come back and deal with the cotangent. We can get the period from the graph by subtracting the ending x value, which is pi over 16, minus the beginning x value, which is negative 3 pi over 16. So that works out to be 4 pi over 16, which reduces to pi over 4. Now when we're using letter B to calculate the period for tangent, we know that the period is equal to pi over b, so solving this equation is going to be pretty darn easy. We have pi over b has to equal pi over 4, so pretty obvious that b is equal to 4, and we can write that in. So now we'll look at phase shift, and we'll start off with the tangent. We know that for phase shift, what we look for is what is happening at the y-axis on the unaltered graph of tangent. So when we look, we see that at the y-axis should be that middle point, the root, should be over here on the y-axis. Instead, it has been shifted to the left by pi over 16. So for the tangent graph, it is left by pi over 16. We know that means C is negative pi over 16, which means when you write it in the equation, we're going to be writing x plus pi over 16. So we can come up to our equation and fill that in, x plus pi over 16. Close the parenthesis, close the bracket. Now we're ready to find the vertical shift. And once again, we compare to the unaltered graph of tangent. And we see that this middle point of the five key values should be sitting right up here on the x-axis. Instead, it has moved down by one, which means that d is going to equal negative 1. So we can write that either as plus a negative 1, or we can just write it as minus 1. So here's the equation for the function if it's a tangent. Now, let's look and see what changes or what stays the same if it is a cotangent function. Now, the vertical stretch is the same. It's still stretching by a factor of 2. However, when we compare this to the unaltered graph of cotangent, we see that this graph has definitely flipped over. Normally, cotangent starts from positive infinity and goes down to negative infinity. So for the cotangent graph, it is flipped. Because it's flipped, that means A has to be negative. So A is going to be negative 2. So we come up here and we can write y equals negative 2 cotangent. So B, we know, is controlled by the period. The period is the same. So that means B will be the same. So B is equal to 4. Now the phase shift for cotangent, we're going to have to compare this graph to the graph of unaltered cotangent. And when we do that, we see that at the y-axis should be this first vertical asymptote. So this asymptote should be over here at the y-axis. Instead, it has shifted to the left by 3 pi over 16. For cotangent, the phase shift is left by 3 pi over 16, which means C is negative 3 pi over 16, which means we're going to write x plus 3 pi over 16 in our equation. So we come up here to the equation and we write x plus 3 pi over 16, close the parenthesis, close the bracket, and the vertical shift, when we look at the unaltered graph of cotangent, that middle value also should be here on the x-axis, and instead it has moved down by 1, so the vertical shift is the same, and d is minus 1. So here is the function equation if it's cotangent. In this example, we have to determine two possible equations for the given graph. One will make a tangent, and one will make a cotangent. Now, because this is a decreasing function, it looks most like a cotangent, so maybe we'll start off doing that function equation. So that's y is equal to a times the cotangent of the quantity b x minus c plus d. And then secondly, we'll find a tangent function. So y equals a tangent of quantity b times x minus c plus d. So why don't you go ahead and give this one a try on your own? See if you can find a, b, c, and d for both function equations. Then restart the video when you're ready to check your answers. We know that absolute value of a comes from the vertical stretch or compression of the function, and we can find that by starting at the middle value and see how far it is to get to either the quarter point or the three-quarter point. So from 4 up to 10, we know that's a distance of 6. From 4 down to negative 2, that's also a distance of 6. So we know right away that the absolute value of a is going to be 6. Or you can do the calculation where you have 1 half of that upper point, which is 10, minus the lower point, which is negative 2. We would be taking 1 half of 12, which is 6. So either way, either you're comfortable looking at the graph and just getting the 6 right off of it, or do the calculation. Now, if this is a cotangent graph, we know that this has not been flipped. That means a has to be positive, which means then a is going to equal 6. So let's start writing that in. We've got y equals 6 times the cotangent of the quantity, and we're going to have to figure those out now. We get the period by subtracting the ending x value, which is 2 pi, minus the beginning x value. So let's figure out the x scale. If this is pi, and we see that that is 1, 2, 3 dotted lines over, that means that each dotted line is pi over 3. So this would be 1 pi over 3, which means this is 2 pi over 3. So the starting x value is 2 pi over 3. So we know that means we're going to be subtracting 6 pi over 3 minus 2 pi over 3. And we see that the period is 4 pi over 3. Now when we're using b to calculate the period, we know we have to put pi over b. So solving for b, we'll need to take the b, cross multiply it up to the right hand side. The 4 pi will cross multiply down to the left hand side. And the 3 will cross multiply up to the left hand side. So we can see that b is going to equal 3/4. So we can come up here to our equation and go ahead and enter that in. 3/4 times the quantity x minus. Now to find c, we know we have to do the phase shift. So we'll compare to the unaltered graph of cotangent, and we can see that at the y-axis for cotangent should be that first vertical asymptote, and instead that asymptote has been shifted to the right by 2 pi over 3. So for cotangent, it's gone to the right by 2 pi over 3, which means C is positive 2 pi over 3, which means we're going to write it as x minus 2 pi over 3. To do the vertical shift, we once again go to the graph of the unaltered cotangent and look at what's happening on the x-axis. So on the x-axis should be that middle point, the root, and instead it has shifted up by 4. So because it's going up, we know that D has to be positive 4. So we'll come up here to our equation and put plus 4. And there's our cotangent function equation. So now let's look at what would be different and what would stay the same if we were to write a tangent function equation. Well, first off, we can see right away that compared to unaltered tangent, this graph has been flipped. Normally, tangent is an increasing function. So for the tangent, it is flipped. That means that A has to be less than 0. So A is going to be negative 6 for the tangent graph. So we'll start off writing y is equal to negative 6 times the tangent. We know that the period is the same because the ending value and starting values are still the same. So that means B will be the same, and we get 3/4. Now, the phase shift, if it is a tangent graph, we have to compare to the y-axis of the unaltered tangent. And for the unaltered tangent, the middle point is over here on the y-axis. So that means that that middle point, the root, must have moved from the y-axis over here to this x value. Remember, we're going by pi over 3s. So this is 1 pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, 3 pi over 3. This would be 4 pi over 3. So for tangent, the phase shift is that it has gone to the right by 4 pi over 3. We know that means C is positive 4 pi over 3, which means we're going to write x minus 4 pi over 3 in our equation. So we come up here and write x minus 4 pi over 3. The vertical shift, we look at the x-axis of unaltered tangent, and we see that that middle point should be down there on the x-axis. And instead, it has moved up by 4, so the vertical shift is the same, and we put plus 4. So here's our function equation if it were a tangent.